Hi everyone and welcome back. And in this video we are going to talk about Nest.js with Jest. I mean, we are writing a lot of different kind of test cases, and here in this video we are going to talk about Jest. So Nest.js with Jest, we have already seen how to write unit test cases. Now maybe in this video we will talk about how to write the integration tests, where we have to actually make an API call, store the data in the database, and maybe mock some third-party services which we cannot integrate. Okay, so what we are going to do is we will first walk through to the setup, like how to do a simple setup of the Nest.js. Sorry, Jest with the Nest.js. Jest is a test runner, and it is providing all different set of methods which are going to help us in writing the test cases. Okay, we don't need to worry about using Mocha, Istanbul, NYC. Now we can discard all these libraries and we can focus on only one library, which is Jest. Okay, so how we are going to do this? I already have covered the unit test cases with the Nest.js and Jest. In this video we are going to cover the integration test cases, which are called as a functional or the E2E test cases for the APIs. Okay, here we have written the test cases for the services, and we were creating the So there are different ways in which we have created as test cases. In the first, we have created a stub. You can take a look onto this thing. Here we created actually a mock of a service, right? This not service, and we created a mock of this, and then we are actually calling a method and checking if this particular method has been called or not. This video I already recorded in the same playlist, in the current playlist, and I have discussed about different ways of doing the unit testing of the services and controllers. Now in this video our focus will be a little bit different. Here we will talk about how to do the Jest configurations and how to isolate the unit test cases with the integration test cases. So first of all, this is the basic setup. Here we have Docker Compose, and when you do Docker Compose up, we are spinning up two different databases. So if I do Docker Compose up, it is creating two different databases, the application database and the test database, so that we can also write the integration test and store the data inside the test database. Starter API testing, okay, and the starter API. Now what we are going to do is, let's first create a Jest configuration. We already have a npm script for the Jest. Like here you can see npm run test. But I was facing the issue while passing the environments. So we cannot just pass the environments directly through the npm script. So we have to find a way to pass the runtime environment. Okay, and for that, what I will do is I will create a Jest config.js first inside the project. And we will understand what all those things are. Jest.config.js. This is Jest configuration, and Jest configuration tells us, okay, where are my test cases, what all type of files I'm going to run. So this Jest config is going to run the unit test cases because it is executing this regex spec.ts, but for the end-to-end test cases it is e2e.ts, right? And coverage directory, test environment, node, and the root. This is the root directory, means start from the root and start scanning the file having spec.ts. And setup files. So the setup file is important. Here we are going to set up the environment for our test. So what we can do is, here it is, we are saying test and setup envars.js. So inside a test folder, we can create this particular file that will help us to set up the runtime environment for the test cases. Okay, and what this contains? It contains all the environment variables you wanted to set. For the test environment you can pass, or we already have env.test file. So what we are doing is, we are just telling .env, okay, pick the runtime configuration from the env.test, not from .env. It is a special instruction which we are going to give to Jest to initialize the environment variable and put the things inside process.env from env.test. On this particular step, I also face the challenges in populating the environment variable in the test configuration, but this is the right way. And here you can have env.test in your project. Do we have it? So what it does is, it is just helping us, this setup is helping us to populate the environments from env.test. Okay, there was env.testing file already there. I didn't check that. So here you can set up the node env is there. And now this is how it is going to work. We actually populated the configuration. So whenever you do npm run test, it is going to pick the environments from here. Now you can configure the different database, configure the different configurations for the test environment. We can put that in the env.testing. And you can freely hit the command npm. So here, if I run npm run test, then I can see that unit test cases are running and they are passing. Now let's create a resources for running the E2E test cases. Okay, for the E2E test cases, we already have this just E2E.json. And here we need to do a small change. We need to provide the environment variable also here that we can do in the same way. So here you can see the root directory, test environment, test regex. So we need to pass one file, which is setup files, right? So setup files will tell end-to-end test cases, okay, get the environment variables from this particular file. So while running the end-to-end test cases, we want to hit the test database, not the application database, right? So set environment variable, it's the same file which we already have here, which contains all the configurations. I mean, it is using .env to load the env.test. Okay, so till now things are good. Now what, let's write a script of our test. How we are going to execute the end-to-end test cases? End-to-end tests are like, okay, hit the API using supertest. If you just take a look onto the default test cases which is already created, which is already there, which is app e2e spec.ts, right? What it is, what it contains, it contains the assertions that whenever you are hitting the API v1, like the forward slash, then you are getting 200 and getting hello world. Or you can hit a health check API here to check if your app is healthy. So what we are doing is, we created a module. By create testing module, we are passing app module, and then we are initializing the, we are just bootstrapping the app module, and then we are running the test cases. Like inside it block, we are using supertest, right? And like here you can see request, we are using request module for doing everything. The request module is coming from supertest. Request your path, request app.get http server. Here this is how you will get the server. Request server instance dot get dot put dot post dot delete, and you can expect. So here you can write const data equal to await, const app equal to await, and then app dot status, all these things you can assert. App instance, app request, or anything. So this is how you are going to call this, and this is await, so you have to convert this into async function. Okay, now what you can do is, you can just inspect the response.body, response.status, all these things you can do in this simple end-to-end test cases. This is how we are going to write the 10 test cases API v1, let's say. Here I have exposed the Swagger spec, API v1, and then expect 200. You can just simply do this, and then you can just do expect. What you can do is response dot status dot equals 200, and this expect assert and all these things you have to import from your libraries. Let's say, like, if I wanted to use these assertions, expect and then equals, so there are different assertions we can use. So we can use jest only for that, to get all these things. So how we can import jest? Import everything as jest, and then we can write, okay, this response status code should be equal to this, should be equal to that. So what we are doing is, expect response.status.2 equals it should be to equal 200. Okay, similarly you can write something else here. Expect response dot status 201 or whatever you are doing. Like if you are doing post, then you might be returning 201, right? So these kind of test cases you will be seeing when we are writing the test case for our APIs. So currently if you run this, we are already running Docker Compose up. So that will spin up the containers for us, and then we can do npm run start debug. That will start our application. So we will know what all APIs we already have in the application. Like I will just do npm run start. So it will show me the swagger on port 3000. There I can just start checking it. So it should be npm run start if start debug is not there. So let's go and check the package.json and see if we have the script there or not. npm run start. Okay, this is start prod. So it is not using NodeMon. I mean, you can also use NodeMon for this. My bad, I'm actually running all these commands in the root folder. Everything is already there. npm run start debug is there. You can see start debug, it is using NodeMon, and NodeMon is running the source main.ts file. But when you build and deploy this, then you will be executing these commands on the Heroku, on the EC2, because we will be running the .js compiled file, and we have to run the migration first before restarting the application or deploying the application. Okay, it will start our application, and then we should be able to write the end-to-end test cases. So for integration with Jest, what all basic things you need. Now I don't have the other modules which we were using earlier. So now I can just use TS Jest and Jest. These are two primary modules which I need to add in my dependencies, dev dependencies. And then inside package.json, you can also define this thing. This is like a Jest dependency which is saying, okay, what is the coverage directory. So either you define this in the package.json or create a jest.config.js. Both are same. Either you do this or either you create a jest.config.js file. Okay, so these are different things which you can do with the application. Now what we will do is we have to set up the test environment. So what are the basic steps for it? So what we are going to do is we are going to write end-to-end test case. So what we want, we also want to seed the data. And before running tests, we have to truncate. So like this is a before each test case, seed the data. After each test case, just clean the database table. So our test cases will not be using some garbage data generated from the previous test case. So it will be like we should be able to run each and every test independent. So this seed and truncate, this is actually utility we have to write to create the test environment, and we have to use the database module only. And we, like, let's say you have 10 different entities in your system, so you will be creating 10 different entity JSON or seed files to populate the data from those tables to your database, test database. So whenever you are running a test, you can already get the user ID which is already there in the seed. You can use the company ID, user ID, or any IDs. So that in that particular case, you don't need to create user, you don't need to create a organizations, like prerequisite data. You can already seed in database. And to keep your tests independent and clean, you always need to truncate the tables once your single test is done. Okay, so that is the next approach and next thing we are going to do. Okay, let's now write the test cases. Before that, we can see our application. So this is our application, right? And when I try to create nodes, so these are like basic APIs. You can see get CRUD operation, you can consider them. Okay, so what is the problem here? If we try to see, okay, the table doesn't exist, right? So what we need to do, we need to run the migration. We forgot to run the migration. So first of all, Let's go to our folder 07 npm run build, and then we need to run the typeor migration. There is a script for that, npm run migration run. Guys, right, these are, like, you can say the APIs you have created. Now you want to test these APIs. So what are the different ways to test it? You will be writing the end-to-end test case, right? So here, go to your tests, and here we can create notes e2 is spec.ts, right? So here we will write our code that we are going to test then the notes API. We can copy the existing structure. But before that, what we are focused on, okay, how to seed the data and how to truncate so that we can have our application up and running. I mean, your test case should be clean. So you want to seed the data as a prerequisites, and you wanted to drop the data once the test case is done. So the next test case will get the clean data. Okay, that is the overall objective. So what we can do for this, we have to write a data DB utils. So in the inside a test, we can create one folder, utils. Inside utils, we are going to create a utility that is a database utility. Okay, and what it is going to do is, it is like an injectable service, you can say, and it is going to seed the data, insert, update, all these things it will be doing. I mean, sometimes what you want is, you want to seed the data, like the seeding the some of the nodes. So what we can do is, we can create index.ts. And then start writing the test util. Here we are going to access the database service. So first of all, let's create a database service in your DB module. Currently, I think we don't have any, okay, we already have a DB service. What this DB service is doing, this DB service is giving us the repository for the entity we are passing. You can see we exposed one method, get repository, and we are using type ORM. So using this database service, we should be able to get the entity repository of a particular table. Okay, this is a simple thing, like we created a service inside a DB module. We already have created this in the previous examples. Now we wanted to create a test utils, and what test util will do is, it is going to do a lot of things. I mean, it will be able to help you to seed the data, close the connection, open the connection, and truncate the tables and all. I will copy this from the template. So I copied this from the typeorm GitHub page. This is how you can do this. You will be importing the database service and all. So first we will just copy all these things. And then we also have to provide the seed data in some files. So we'll take a look how we can provide that. So we have database service. Now we can use database service in our methods. Okay, so what all methods we have? First is the get entity. So from database service, we will get all the entities, and we are just generating, we are just collecting all the entities which exist in the type ORM, like all the tables. Then we have another method which are like reload fixture. This is the method which your each and every test is going to execute. What reload fixture does is, it is going to seed the data. I mean, it is going to clean the data and load the new data for your entities. So reload fixture is something which you are going to call after the end of each and every test. So we have two methods, clean all and the load all. So I will just copy this from the template code. I'm not writing it. I will just explain you what I'm trying to do to seed the data in the type ORM NestJS environment. Okay, let's see this, what we are trying to do. So you can see we have load all and we have, let me just move this out. We have two different methods. Reload fixture is something which you are going to call. First of all, get all the entities, type ORM entities, and pass those same entities into clean all and the load all method. Clean all means truncate all the tables. Load all means seed the data into the respective tables. Entities is like an array of name and the table name, entity name and the table name which exists in the database, right? And we are passing it to the clean all and the load all. Clean all is giving you the repository, and from that you are doing a query. Truncate table, table name, truncate table, table name. So you are truncating all the entities. Like if you are having 10 entities, you truncate all. And then load all. Load all means you are again getting the repository from the database service, and you need a feature file. You need some seed data file using which you can send the data to the database. You can feed the data or seed the data to the database. So what we can do is we can have the entity JSONs. So there is an entity name with the same name. We can have the JSON file created inside some folder. So what is our entity name first? Go to our module entity. So what is our entity name? That is actually the class name. So here we can say note. So we can create note.json file inside our test. So inside test, you can see there is a utils and it is looking for fixture. So inside text, we have fixtures. Okay, inside that we can have all the entities. Inside that we have entity. And inside this we will have notes.json. That's it. And this is how we can seed the data. Entity and not.json, because we are going to read this file while loading the data. And here we will put the data, like what data you wanted to export. This is a JSON document, so it will be like some set of records you wanted to put. So we will put multiple records. So this is the ID. What all other columns we have in this notes entity, we'll put all these. So there is ID, text is completed, right? ID, text is completed. Just construct a valid JSON. Okay, this is your first object. Similarly, you can create another object. This is like your database record. All right, ID, you just change it because this is the primary key. You will get error if you are trying to insert the duplicate records. So this is your seed data we have created, and the seed data we are reading through this utility, load all. Fixture, entity, entity name. We got the fixture file. If file exists, then we are doing json.parse, right? We are getting individual record. And for all those records, we are just doing a bulk insert. Entity.name, insert and execute. So this is our test setup. You can say we now have the fixtures, entities and test utils. Okay, now how can I use this test util in my notes test cases? That is another important point, right? We have written the test case, we have written the utilities and all, but how should I start integrating it? So for that, you have to add the dependencies, right? So we have a dependency on the database service. So what we are going to do is, here we have to pass imports, and there is a provider because there are two services we are talking about. Test util is also a service. Okay, so there is a test utils and database service, and we have to get the instance of the test util. Let test utils, and we have to import this thing, and database service we have to import. So test util we can import. I think this should be straightforward. So we are getting the test utils from test. Okay, so we have to go back. I guess we can't, this cannot be used like this. So first we are going above. Okay, so this is how we are importing test utils. Similarly, we can import the database service, SRCDB, and we need to provide the proper path. SRC, I think it's inside app, right? SRC app DB, or where it is? SRC, okay, SRC DB. There is nothing like app. Okay, DB, and inside DB we have a db.service. Okay, now it should resolve. So we are importing all these things. Now what we are going to do is, before running each and every test case, we have to call this method. First of all, get the test util instance. How we can get the service instance using? So this is test utils, and what we can do is we can get it from module reference. So this is actually module reference, await test module fixture, you can say, dot get. This is how we write the test cases in the Nest.js, and this is of type test utils. It is going to give us the instance, and then what we are going to do initially before running everything, test utils dot reload fixture. This method we can execute, reload fixture, and then app dot init. So this is the method, but how, what we are going to do is, we are going to execute this method whenever after each and every execution. So what this reload fixture will do is, before running this whole spec file, we are going to reload, means we are going to truncate the whole tables and we are going to seed the data. This you can put inside before each, after each also. I am doing it at the test level. That means before running this spec, it will do the cleanup of the database and will insert something. And after each, we can add to close the database connection. So we are not doing anything wrong. We are cleaning everything whenever we are moving to another test file. So close DB connection, this is another method which we have to add inside our test utils. So close DB connection is important. Like once you are done with the particular test case, it's important to just shut down the connections, and when the new test come, it will initiate the connection. Okay, so this is a simple close DB connection which you have to add in the test utils. Okay, here is our utils, and here we can call this method close DB connection. It will get the connection from database service. If it is connected, then it will close it. So this is very important test configuration file, test util file, which is giving you all the entities through the type ORM connection. It is helping you to clean all the database using truncate. It is helping you to load the seed data by reading the file and parsing it and writing it. So now you can start writing your test cases for the Nodes API. First of all, let's fix this. What is the problem with this? So I'm going three step back, and then do I have SRC? Okay, I have SRC, then DB, then db.service. Okay, so now let's write the test cases for the nodes. So now let's see everything in action. We are going to create two files, and the first file in this, we are going to test the create operation. Okay, let's say nodes create, and here the rest of all the other operations we are going to test here. But before that, we have to create, right? So for create, it's just a copy of the file, reload fixture, and then here we can say API v1 nodes. We can check this here. What is the API URL? API v1 nodes, and we are hitting the post first because we have to create, right? And this is the payload, simple payload. So what we are going to do is API v1, this is the post. It's API v1 nodes, and here we can use send command, and then we can expect like what the status code we are getting. So this is the data we are sending, and then we can expect response.status equal to 200. Let's see if we are getting 201. Right, so this is the one particular test case. And then here what we can do is, first we will try to create and then get all. So here also we can do get all API v1 notes. This is a get call. We don't need to send anything. We are just checking the status code is 200 or not. Okay, here we can also trigger another API call, get notes by ID. Right, here let's say you create a notes and you got an ID. This is an ID we need to pass here, and then you will get the data. So here you can, we can also assert this API v1 notes. So we are still in the create. Let's move this thing to all the other operations. So in this particular file we are writing all the other test cases. I'm creating two files to show you the how this reload fixture works. So this is, we are doing create. Now in the same test cases, const data, I can just get what I'm getting from request response.body. If we are getting response.body, then we can get the ID from there. Right, so it is like note ID. And I can pass the node ID to my another assertion. Here I am just doing, okay, get this nodes by ID. Right, first I'm creating, then I'm just calling this get call. So this is a post. Okay, we don't need to close it because both the test cases are in the same block. First we are doing create, and then we are just checking that we are able to get the ID or not. Get note by ID. Here we are first creating the note. So similarly, you can actually do update, delete, and all these operations, and you can just check the status code. So here the test cases will fail if we are putting 200, 201, like the create should return 201. And then we are just doing get by ID. Similarly, there are other operations also. Let's say we want to delete, patch and all. So we can also do this. Here, if we are doing delete, it is simple response. Just change the variable name, response 2 or 3, response 3.status. It should be 204. Let's see, no content. Yes. And before doing everything, it is reloading the fixture. And now we will see the magic, because what we are doing here is, in this notes we are doing, first of all we are creating it, and then we are also trying to get the length of the notes. Here also we can try to do one thing, response.body.length. Let's say, because two records are out there, three. And first of all we will try to execute this. So we can do describe dot only. Not sure if this can work in the jest. In the jest, you have to pass the file name only if you wanted to run a particular test case, not the describe dot only. Okay, now we can run these test cases. So what we can do is, first of all, there are other few things also. We are running this in the test. So do we have test database tables created? Yes or no? So for that, what we will do is, we will populate the test tables using test migration. So let's go here, npm run test e2e. Okay, we don't need these things because we now passing everything inside config set environment variable. So test e2e, before that we will do is test migration npm run test migration, there should be one command which is talking about test migration. If it is not there, we will create one. So test migration is nothing but it is like you are running the migration for the test environment. So it should be test migration. So we have to pass env.test, test migration run. So it will create the table in the test environment. And then whenever you are doing, whenever you are running end-to-end test cases, we will execute test migration first, and then we will run our end-to-end test cases based on this file. So here we have written the test cases. There are two files, notes create and notes operation, right? And we have already set up all the configurations for the end-to-end tests. This is the seed file we have created, right? And now here we can see the notes.test, and what we are doing here is we are already reloading the fixtures, which is going to clean the database and load the seed for each and every file. Like there are two files, so it is going to happen. And here we are creating a note and getting the ID of it, and then getting the note, it will give 200, and then we are deleting it. So how to run this? We can just do a simply npm run test end to end. It will actually check if there is any pending migration. If not, then it will just execute the end to end test. So what it is doing, you can see. We also have to add the migration step. I think that is removed, because for running the end-to-end test case, we need to have the database tables already created. So this is npm run test end-to-end. What we can do is we can just do npm run test migration, and test migration is this. Okay, so it is running the notes e2espec.ts, and then it will run the another test. You can see the command here. We put the silent because to silent the logs which are coming. Run in band means it will execute the one e2e test case at a time. Sometimes when you are doing a parallel execution, then you can see the connection timeouts and all from the database side. So we are running one test case at a time. Okay, this has been passed. Now it is calling notes create, and we can also see that this seed and drop is happening or not. So for that, what we can do is we can enable the logs. So from the dbmodule.ts, what we will do is we will enable the logs. So here is our dbmodule. Here there is a parameter logging, just enable it to true, and then we will also remove the silent flag from the npm script. So we can see things are coming up, like the logs of dropping the, truncating the records and inserting the records. So npm run test e2e, we can just run it with logs. So I will execute this command again, npm run test e2e. It will just check, do we have any migrations? This is ideally how we should write it on the local. We should run the test migration. If there is any table needs to be updated before running the test, and then it will run the actual test cases, the end-to-end test cases, by looking into the files, and it is looking into a test database. There is no new migration, so nothing happened. And now it will start executing our tests. And my expectation is we should get the logs of whatever is happening, because I have removed the silent flag. Otherwise I will see how we can show all the logs which are being generated. Okay, so this is the whole setup of end-to-end test of with the type ORM and the Postgres. What we did is if we have multiple tables, write multiple cedar files, entity.json files, and then every time whenever you are executing the end-to-end test cases, this is actually truncating and loading the fresh data for the latest test case you are running. So your test cases are independently executable. They are not going to be impacted by other response coming from the other test case, right? Why I'm saying my test cases are independent, always use this approach. I mean, in this particular test case, first I'm creating it, then I'm not creating another it block to get the ID. In the same block, I'm getting the ID and trying to get the note and then deleting the note. So if you try to divide this into the three it block, then they needs to be dependent. You have to use note ID as a global variable and reassign it. In that case, the other two test cases will be dependent on the first create note test case. And obviously, if this one fails, all other two will also fail. But I can see that query, this is just a query log, right? And it is taking too much time. Maybe my system is slow while it is deleting and truncating. I will try to run this again. And then we will see, you can see it is doing the inserts. It is doing the truncate. You can see it is inserting that inside a notes. And then also once the things are done, it is cleaning up that table. Okay, out of three, one has failed. That might be due to, because I'm running this on the Docker container, but this is just to visualize, okay, how things will work. It is actually truncating the table, because we have only single entity. Then it is inserting inside that, and then it is running the test case. Okay, so that's it, guys. I will commit the whole code to the GitHub, so you can also take a look how this whole thing is running and whole thing is working, and this setup is on the Docker. Thanks, everyone.